Welcome to the 311 Griffin YouTube channel. We're talking about The Witcher today, specifically the Witcher miniseries on Netflix, and very specifically the Blaviken fight scene at the end of episode 1, which was the best scene in the entire series. Spoiler alert, sorry. we're talking about a lot here today, but that's specifically what we want to talk about. Before we get into that, I want to do a little bit of an introduction. So, if you're not familiar with the Witcher series, you're probably not necessarily sure how you got here. But I'm assuming most of people watching this video are familiar with it. But for me personally, I don't love everything about the story, but I think that the recognition that the story has gotten, whether that's the books, the video games, or the miniseries, is well deserved, because the universe that this is set in is full of deep and very profound story arcs, interesting dynamic characters. The world building is extremely rich. There are intricate political and economic systems in the story, and those come out in the books, the video games, and in a bit in the miniseries. And so even though I don't necessarily like everything about the story, I think that it's well worth your time if you're into kind of high fantasy sort of stories. So the games are where I got introduced to The Witcher, and I felt like The Witcher 3 was just a really dynamic game. Of course, it also has Gwent, which is amazing to play, but the fighting is a little bit different than what I'm used to. The story is a little bit different. It's I still think that in many ways I prefer the Elder Scrolls universe, but The Witcher 3 was vastly different, and it was it really went above and beyond my expectations. So I read the books, all but one of them now. There's one that I lack that I haven't read yet, but the books, again, there's things that I don't necessarily love about the books, but in general, they're just really, really rich and full. So it's well worth your time to read if you're into that kind of stuff. And if you've played The Witcher 3 or any of the other Witcher games, you really should read the books. If you've watched the miniseries, and that's your only experience with The Witcher universe, then you should probably read the books. I think that if you enjoyed it at all, if you enjoyed the miniseries at all, you should read the books. They're really, really good. So now I want to talk about Geralt a bit, because I think that it's important to recognize that he's not the central character to the story. Obviously, Ciri is. But I think it's also important to point out that there are a lot of other characters in this universe that are more powerful and more willing to be the center point. But really, the genius, I think, of the story is putting Geralt at kind of the center. He's not the pivotal character, but he's sort of what everything revolves around. And he himself is kind of unwilling to play that role, but he plays it anyway. And that gives us a lot of kind of real-world insights into his character and why he is the way he is. So one of the things about Geralt that I think is important is that he didn't really choose his profession. It was forced on him. He didn't have any choice in becoming a Witcher, and you see that a lot in all of the various stories. He deals with that constantly. He accepts it. He takes ownership of it, because there's not much else he can do, and he does the best job that he possibly can. But because of that, he kind of relates to monsters and to elves and dwarves. In this universe, elves and dwarves aren't like they are in a lot of other high fantasy. They are looked down upon by the humans. And so Geralt has a lot of empathy for not just them, but for the monsters as well. He also distrusts humans, and humans distrust him. They don't really understand him. Some of the things they distrust him for are true, and some of them aren't. And he's clearly given up on kind of correcting people. He just lives in this world and does the best he can on his own. But he's a bit of a loner for those reasons. He also really respects life, and that's something that I think is extremely important in the stories. Oftentimes, Geralt, he would prefer to cure a cursed monster rather than kill them if he can, and he goes out of his way to do it, sometimes to his own detriment. And there are a lot of points in the game and in the books And you see it a little bit in the miniseries where he really does take on greater risks and lower rewards to do exactly that. So I think that that's really important. He's fair and honest. He, you know, the Witchers are a dying breed in this universe, and they are singularly capable of doing what they do. So Witcher services would be in high demand in a world where there are lots of monsters and evil people, and there aren't that many Witchers. So Geralt should be able to charge whatever he wants for his services, but the world is also very, very poor, and some of the more powerful people that could pay him more, they have things on him where, you know, they can kind of force him to do what they want for less. So he can't charge what he's worth, but he often charges to chooses to charge less than what he could. You know, he very regularly leaves people with something. He could take their last dime, but he often leaves them with something to live on whenever he's done. So anyway, Geralt winds up being really conflicted, where he doesn't necessarily trust people, but he wants to be fair with them anyway. He seems to feel like he's a monster, which is reinforced by the people around him. You know, but at the same time, he proves to be kind of the least monstrous thing in the universe, you know. So he's treated like a monster. He sometimes thinks he's a monster, but he's the furthest thing from a monster, because he's so fair and honest. You know, so I think that's important, and one of the reasons why he makes a great central character, mostly just because he doesn't want to. He doesn't want to be the central character, so he makes a great one. So he also displays true confidence, which I think true confidence and true humility are kind of the same thing. So he doesn't look for fights. He doesn't eagerly correct people when he has more knowledge than they do based on his experience. But he's not afraid to correct people when he needs to. And so that kind of leads us into this Blaviken fight scene, because I think that the fight scene really sort of shows the kind of person that Geralt is, and why he's a good example in most cases of you know, true confidence and true manhood, I guess. So what we're going to see is he's reluctant to fight, and he's frustrated that he has to fight. He has patience and awareness. He doesn't force things, but when he does do things, he's decisive and brutal. And then he has great tactical ability through training and experience, the ability to use signs, and his adaptation to use weapons that aren't necessarily his, or that he's not necessarily used to or doesn't choose to use. So we're going to see that in this fight. And again, this is the best scene in the entire series, and I think it really encompasses what Geralt is all about. Okay, here's the fight scene at the end of episode 1. This is the Blaviken scene, and it is the point in the story where Geralt gets the nickname Butcher of Blaviken. And we will see the various personality traits, skills, and abilities kind of thrown in here together, at least some of them that Geralt has. I have the speed slowed down to 50% just so that I can kind of catch everything and talk about it as it happens. And also I have the sound down so I can talk over it. So if you want to see the actual scene full speed and with sound, I highly recommend it if you haven't. So just go to Netflix and watch it, you know. You might be able to find it on YouTube, but I would just recommend going to the source. But anyway, I think that's it for the introduction to the fight scene. Let's just watch it here. First of all, it just sounds funny whenever people are talking and the speed is slowed down. But what we're seeing here is Geralt has an objective. He's made a decision, and he's the type of character where once he's made a decision, he sees it through. He doesn't go back on promises he's made. He doesn't leave people behind. Sometimes he's tempted to, but and of course, if they deserve it, he might leave them behind if they've gotten themselves into trouble.
he might leave him behind, but typically he doesn't leave him behind. But he is very reluctant. He's got this objective. These guys are in his way. He doesn't want to fight them, but they're forcing him to, and he doesn't like it. So here he also has really good tactical awareness. This kind of slow-mo shot is sort of a la Sherlock Holmes. And Geralt has really good tactical awareness based on where people are and what they have. And then his reflexes are just amazing. Here we see the absolute brutality of what he's doing, which encompasses, once he makes the decision to take care of business, he takes care of business, and he uses any means necessary to do it. So there, he took that guy's sword with him, and at 50% speed, things are happening so fast, I can't really talk about them. So we're gonna back it up. Okay, so he parries the arrow, which is something that is in the books and games, so it's good that they showed that. Here he deflects twice and then just brutally murders this guy to clear him out. And then here's a deflect and sort of a dodge. Hurts the first guy, deflects that hatchet, takes care of that guy. Block, kills that guy. Takes the sword with him, does a block, gets this guy in a position to literally disarm him, and then, that's my favorite part, just chucks the sword at that guy. So he's using weapons as well as he can. He's using his sword, and Henry Cavill does this just really awesome. He does an awesome job at this. But you see he's using the sword in ways that aren't conventional. And I think that that's important. But he's kind of lining people up and doing his dodges and his parries and his blocks. And it's just really kind of cool to watch. Disarmed. And then chuck right into that guy. So here we see Ard. He's using a sign. Oh, I hadn't noticed that before. Look at his hand when he does the Ard sign. I'm going to have to look it up and see if that's pretty correct. I bet it is. Because I think Henry Cavill is a really good actor. And he's honestly the best part of the show. But anyway, the Ard there tactically I don't think was that big of a deal. Although it kind of staggered these guys and maybe made it so he could fight them one-on-one. But other than that, it was just good that it showed him using a sign. And then this poor guy should have ran. I don't know why. I don't like scenes where they just stand there looking at each other. And then one of them strikes. But anyway, it's the last guy, so whatever. The next fight after this one is kind of like that. He and the girl just kind of stand there looking at each other half the time. But there you have it. That's the Blaviken fight scene. And, you know, I know I was talking over it. I know it's slow. It's not like you're watching the scene in its entirety and cleanly. So I apologize for that and the brutality. But that's just part of the story. Hopefully that all makes sense. Like this fight scene really shows off Geralt's abilities, and I love the beginning when he's reluctant. He does not want to have this fight. And then later, I'm not showing this part, but later when the town turns against him, which is fairly realistic, you know, if somebody came in and just brutally, I'm not going to say murdered. I said that before during the kind of play-by-play. But came in and just brutally killed people, even if they deserved it. A town wouldn't really want that person around. So they turn against him, and he doesn't, you know, he's frustrated by it. He's angry by it, but, you know, it's not like he can kill the whole town, and he doesn't want to. So he just kind of gets what he needs and leaves the town, and they're throwing stuff at him and everything. So he just took care of some bad guys. The town turns against him, and he leaves. So the bookends of this fight, I think, are really important too. And so I'll wrap this up. While I did not like the miniseries that much, it was entertaining. I enjoyed watching it. It's just that there were a lot of areas where I thought they could have done better, specifically not jumping around at least three different timelines. I think officially three different timelines, in a really confusing way, so that even people who were familiar with the story got confused. But aside from that and a few other issues, it was enjoyable. It was good, but this was the capstone of the entire series so far, and I hope they put more things like this in future seasons. With that, I think I'll wrap it up, and thank you for watching.
Come, child. The eternal fire will soothe your pain.
Leave me be. Your pay will await you at Crow Perch. Collected there.